All right, welcome back to some more easy blues harmonica, and today we're going to work on our groove and going to get it so that basically when you're playing solo you can play something like this. Before, but it's really important to work on these sort of fundamentals and keep reinforcing them over time. This is something that I like to practice every day. It's fun and it's an important thing, helps make the song sound cool. Alrighty, so that's got rid of all the people that just come looking for new stuff. Actually, learning to groove is difficult. We're going to just do like a one chord groove today. A lot of people don't play one chords, they don't like them. They're actually quite difficult. Like, it takes a lot of skill to put a nice groove into things, because it's not something that you think about, it's something that you play. Like for today, for example, I want to restrict ourselves, so we're just going to use a one of the chord, a flat seven, and a flat three. That gives us like heaps of notes to work with, a lot of textures there. And yeah, we'll easily be able to get like a nice groove going, which is what I was playing before. All right, so how do we learn to do that? To learn, I like to have a really solid, steady beat. So I normally play with a metronome, which lives inside my telephone, which is recording this. But I've tracked down some drum tracks to play along with on YouTube. And I've got a snare drum track here that's got like a nice accented beat on the one and then plays around for the rest of the bar. So nice, simple. It'll just help us keep in time. It's also a nice simple drum beat so that basically the rest of the band isn't making the groove. It's all up to you. So let's get it running in the background and play.
65
beats per minute, so very slow. Cool. So, as you know, for me, the most important thing as I listen to the backing track there is I like to accent the 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't have to accent the 1, but that's my sort of thing. And I like to really get on that note. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. All right, so how are we going to do that? Today, we're actually going to play in fifth position. Another thing I've hidden to keep away from the people that are only looking for new stuff. We've never played in fifth position before. So how do we do it? Fifth position, minor pentatonic scale, is 2 blow, 2 draw, 3 draw double bend, 3 draw, 4 draw, and 5 blow. Sounds like this. All right, why would I want to play that scale? I'll tab it out because we don't need to use a lot of the scale, but I would expect you to go exploring that now that you know a new position. So why do I want to use that scale? Like I said, I want to restrict myself in this. I only want to use the 1, the flat 7, and the flat 3rd. What better way to do that than to put everybody in a new scale where they're not sure where the notes are? So the 1 is 2 blow, the flat 7 is 1 draw, and the flat 3rd is 2 draw, also 3 blow. That's a nice one, give you a chance to balance out your breath a little bit. So basically, I'm doing 1, flat 7, 3. Finish back on the 1. So again, our 1 is 2 blow, our flat 7 is 1 draw, and our flat 3rd is 2 draw or 3 blow. So let's get that little groove happening that I was playing before. So there's our 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4. So 2 blow on the 1. Thank you. Excellent. How do we make it sound cool? All right. So the first thing is to get, in my opinion, really solid. So I'm not going to embellish this one and make it sound cool. I'm going to be really solid and really short. 3, 4. Nice. Once you've got that really short, listen in your head and try and get your notes to start as the stick hits the skin of the snare. That is what we're going to focus on for our groove. A lot of people talk about pushing and pulling the beat, playing before the beat, playing after the beat. My teacher Jason says, play on the beat. And that's really all he told me about grooving. So yeah, focus on getting on that beat. Once you've got on the beat, you can do stuff with the rest of your notes. I'll show you again. I'll just going to extend the time that I play the notes for. So, get a nice strong focusing on accenting that one of the scale on that, and from there we're just moving through. So we've got our flat 7 back to our 1, flat 3 back to our 1. Basically that's because that's how the harp lays out. All right, why are we doing it in fifth position? Fifth position on a C harmonica lets you play in E, and the person who is the best in the world, in my opinion, at doing one chord grooves is John Lee Hooker. And I hid this for the end, for the people that actually watch these to the end of the video, because today I was listening to John Lee Hooker play a song. This is off a recording from the 60s. This is actually on a commercial record. It's not a tutorial, where he's talking about how to teach the blues. John plays in E quite a lot. So to play in E on our C harmonica, we need to play in fifth position. So we're going to, it's the same speed, 65 beats per minute, it's around there. So we're going to listen to what John's saying. And while we're doing that, we're going to groove in the background. We're going to use the same notes, just that 2, blow 1, draw 2, 3, 1, 2, draw 1. It's hard, too many notes. 2, blow 1, draw 2, blow 2, draw 2, blow 1, draw 2, blow 2, draw. That's what we're going to do. Nice and quietly in the background, listen to John, and we're going to groove, because this is the man that knows how to do it. All right. Teaching the blues off. That's where it's at. John Lee Hooker.
Now, yeah, you're the chord here. I want to show you.
So here where the one is.
A whole lot of people ask me where I originated my beat from, but I heard from way back, a long time ago. I am just starting out in the music world, professional, but I was born with this show. I just discovered started. show you something on that about this chord, you know. Hold your hand right there and then work your thumb, kind of beat like. It's not, you know, a lot of chords to it, but just a big beat. Now sound just like a whole band. You dig it. And dig my feet. You can do it if you try. Yes, yes, with a big soul. Now you're cooking with gas. Yes, the pot's on now. Oh, you're working now.
How John grooves. Simple stuff. Hypnotic. Constantly repeating. Gets you in that groove. Yeah. And our minor pentatonic scale. Tabs in there. Have some fun. Ha ha ha.